So, good afternoon, friends. And today we are meeting again with the same topic, the biochemic system of medicine. Since 3-4 days we are learning this biochemic system of medicines, it looks like that there are only 12 remedies. But if you go with the theory, you will understand the depth of biochemic system of medicine. In fact, I will say that it is more scientific from the scientific world, because everything is mentioned with the help of a material aspect, and that's why it looks like a more scientific as compared to the homeopathic. Today's lecture we are going to understand the depth of it. I know that in today's lecture the theoretical part is rather big. I think it is 17 or 18 slides are there, but every slide is important and gives you that even in homeopathy, when we go through the biochemic system of medicine, we can find it out the scientificness. And very nicely Schussler has mentioned, gathered it from different books and different peoples and added in his book and given the total scientific view to his understanding of the system. So today's session, little bit lengthy, maybe 2 or 3 lectures will require, but we'll go sentence by sentence. Every sentence is useful to understand. And that's why a very warm welcome to all of you, and we'll just revise what we have learned in earlier lectures. We have started with the theory in the first lecture, and we have learned what is exactly the concept of this 12 tissue salts. So it maintains harmony at cellular and tissue levels. If they are in proper quantity, the chemico-physiological equilibrium is maintained. If there is deficiency of any salt or salts, it reflects in disturbance of molecular motion of them, ultimately disturbs the equilibrium and expresses the disease. If you fulfill this deficiency by providing the required salt, the minimum quantity, in minimum quantity, that is in the semi-dynamic doses, the equilibrium is again maintained. What are these semi-dynamic doses? That we're going to discuss in today's lecture. And thereafter, we have learned the first remedy, that is the calcarea fluor. And everyone have understood the calcarea fluor, that diseases having their seat of disturbance in the specifically the surface of bone, enamel of teeth, or parts of elastic fibers which are there on the skin, connective tissues, or the walls of the blood vessel, and the pathologies related with it generally happens to be there, treated very successfully with the help of a calcarea fluor. And if you go through these lectures again on the video, you can find it out, or go through the book and you'll learn that calcarea fluor again, and you'll never forget, and you'll use successfully the calcarea fluor. Thereafter, we have learned with the another remedy, that is calcarea fos. And again, some part of theory regarding how the formation of tissues happens with the help of these inorganic salts, and how they mix the different tissues formation as well as the degradation which happens, and how to take out those eliminative products from the elimination system ultimately depends upon these inorganic salts. And that concept he has elaborated in that specific theoretical part, and he has given the calcarea fos over there. The third slide, which is related with the calcarea. Then calcarea fos, we have discussed a wide variety than the calcarea fluor, and calcarea fos we can get ample things regarding the calcarea fos. Different actions, bones, basically the regeneration or formation of cells or tissues and bony fractures, everywhere the calcarea fos is useful. And even as a general tonic to give the strength to the human being, it is very good, specifically for growth factors or for height problems, the patient comes, the calcarea fos plays a very vital role. So this is what we have learned in the second lecture. The third lecture, it has been devoted to the calcarea self, a very short lecture, yesterday's lecture, and we have discussed a short topic of theoretical issue, the Schussler's concept of health and disease. And in this concept, we have learned again the revision of that, the disturbance at the molecular level of the any inorganic salt reflects its own features in that specific part, producing certain pathology which is related with that function of that inorganic salt. and ultimately reflects in the disease. Till the molecular motions of all these salts, 12 tissue salts, happens to be the normal inside the body, a person is called to be healthy. But if that disturbance happens, it ultimately expresses in the form of a disease. And then we have discussed in short regarding the Calcarea salt, because this is the short remedy which is mentioned by Schussler over there. And in there is one thing also mentioned by him, that in last editions, German editions, he has removed this Calcarea salt from his book as a 12 tissue salt, because this has only appearance in the liver, in the bile, and it takes out the water from the dead RBC, and when it gets absorbed completely, that RBC can be get absorbed or taken away from the eliminating system through the lymphatics or blood vessel. But if it never happens at that time, generally the whatever the material is there, albuminous, necrosed, diseased material is there, it remains over there for a longer time, it becomes tardy, and then it finds it out somewhere vent. And that's why it ultimately finds it out vent at the level of a skin, and you have ultimate pathology is the purulent discharge, exudations all over the body in the form of small abscesses, boils, or yellowish mucopurulent discharges, which happens to be there with the calcareous cell. So we have learned regarding these three remedies. Today we'll go ahead, first understand the dose aspect, and this you have to understand very clearly. Very nicely he has mentioned regarding these dose. A big, yes, we'll read sentence by sentence in order to understand the scientificity of this. So dose or quantity of tissue salt required to re-establish normal cell equilibrium. He has given the reference why it is required in minimum quantity, how much minimum, and how it works. Biochemic remedies are administered in minimal doses corresponding to the minuteness to the cellular salts in the tissue. The curative virtue of small doses may be deduced from the following facts. So small doses ka daiche, the khup facts tene vegvegle dakhavle. There are n number of examples he has given in order to explain why it is required in minimum quantity. Throughout the nature, atoms and groups of atoms or molecules form the basis of our operations. The growth of animals and plants is the accretion of new atoms or groups of atoms to the existing mass of molecules. So everywhere, if you'll find it out in the world, you'll find that these growths are dependent upon the things which are required in very, very minute quantity. If you'll see the plants, how they develop, how much amount they require, if you'll find it out the ingredients to develop the plant, it is so minimum. If you'll find with the human being, it is so minimum quantity which is required. It is not required in big material. And this is the thing. Then he has given a lot of scientific explanation. We'll go ahead. In the view of the fact of the action of light itself, imponderable, causing molecule movement in the living plants, by which carbonic acid is decomposed into the carbon and oxygen, and again the action of light on the photographic plate and retina of the eye, it seems impossible for contradiction that in infinitely small imponderable particles of matter can act upon the living body. He has given two examples, that light, which makes, there are n number of minute particles which are not even visible to your eyes number of time, and which acts on that specific photographic plate. And it works. It reflects the changes inside the plant leaves, and there is a typical photosynthesis happens, and with the help of that, it releases carbon and oxygen. See, this happens with the so minuteness. Or he has given one more example, that same light appears, or it comes on the retina and producing its effects on the retina, and producing, you can find it out or you can watch, because of those fine particles appears or acts on your retinal plate, reflects in the form of a vision, and you find it out. The quantity is invisible or infinitesimal. The use of small doses in biochemical treatment is a chemico-physiological necessity. So how much quantity is required? it is it which work which should work at the chemico-physiological level. That is so important. It should work at that molecular level. For instance, it is desired to have globular salts reach the blood. Anyone knows globular salt? Globular salt is nothing but the sodium. It is the sodium sulfate decahydrate. So in our system, it is the natrum sulfuricum. Glauber was the person. He was the John Glauber from the Hungary, who has first found it out that salt from, and he has prepared that salt from the Hungarian spring water, and that's why his name is given to this natrum sulfuricum as a Glauber salt. So he has given one more example. For instance, it is desired to have Glauber salt reach the blood. It cannot be done by giving it in a concentrated solution. Only in intestinal canal is affected thereby, producing a watery diarrhea, which the salt is cast out from the organism. But a diluted solution of this salt, natrum sulfuricum, will enter the blood and intracellular fluids from the mouth and esophagus, and by virtue of hygrometric property will induce the passage of an excess of water in the tissues into the venous blood and increase the urinary secretion. See, if it has been given in material form more, it will produce its effects directly under the primary action. But if same salt is given in minute doses, like a biochemic doses, 3x, 6x, 4, 5x, so these will work in a different manner. See, this is what he wants to explain, that the material which is given in the material form or a quantity works in a different manner. And same thing, if it has been given in the minute doses, it works with a different action. And this is what he wants to impose on your mind. N number of examples he has given. Every biochemical remedy must be sufficiently diluted to avoid destroying the functions of healthy cells and to restore the disturbed functions wherever present. See, this is also one more important thing. Whenever you are giving biochemical remedy, it must be sufficiently diluted. Diluted means it is potentized up to certain level, or it must be degraded in such a manner. In the healthy organism, animal or vegetable, the salts are found in solution corresponding to the third, fourth, fifth decimal dilutions of medicines. Here, sugar salts, these are there in our body, and they are in this specific level, third, fourth, fifth decimal dilutions. So it is in 3x, 4x, 6x level. He has given the quantity also, and you can find it out on the basis of that quantity that you will require 3x, 6x, 4x, 5x, because it is present in that specific quantity in your body. And that is what is the understanding behind the biochemical doses. So it is not more than 12x generally, because it is required in that specific quantity inside the body. So we'll go ahead, then you will understand the things. This is very important part which he has mentioned over there. See, this is scientificity. The following table of analysis of blood cells in relation to human organism will show this. In 1000 grams of blood cells, the amount of inorganic substances are, according to Bunch's textbook of physiological and pathological chemistry, as follows. And see, in 1000 grams of blood cell madhe kay kay asto? Iron is there, 0.998 milligram. Kali salt is 0.132 milligram. Kali muriaticum is 3.079. Kali phos is 2.343. Natrum phos is 0.333. Natrum means only sodium is 0.344. Calcarea phos or calcium phosphate is there 0.094. And magnesium phosphoricum is there 0.060. See, this much is present inside the blood cell for functioning. So how much requirement is there? It is so minimum. Now he has compared, this he has given in the cell, how much it is present in the cell. Now he has given comparison in relation with the interstitial space. So let us go ahead. Now he has mentioned regarding this. In 1000 grams of intercellular fluid, that is plasma, the proportion of inorganic substance is following. See, here he explains about this. Now it is Kali self. Here iron is not there, intercellular fluid. Here Kali self is there. It is 0.281. Kali more is there, 0.359. Both salts are in minimum quantity in the intercellular fluid. Natrum muriaticum is there, 5.545, which was not there inside the cell. See, this is too important to understand. We'll go up one slide up. No, just up, down. It can go forward. See, this is the slide. You find it out iron over here, and iron is not there in this slide. Intercellular fluid, iron is not there. If you compare it Kali sulfuricum, you'll find 0.132 inside the cell. It is more in outside the cell, 0.281. Kali muriaticum, it is much more inside the cell, 3.079, as compared to very less amount outside the cell. Potassium is more less in outside, it is more inside. Natrum muriaticum, which is outside, which is not there over here, it is not there inside the cell. See, this is what one has to understand. Natrum phosphoricum, it is 0.271 outside and just 0.633, it is less inside the cell. Natrum itself, only sodium, which is 0.344, and here it is more, 1.532 outside the cell. Calcarea phos, 0.298 outside the cell. Calcarea phos is 0.094, very less amount inside the cell. And MacPhos, you'll find 0.060 inside the cell, which is more outside the cell, 0.218. And there are very less traces of the natrum cell, fluor and silica traces. So this is what is the original quantity of these substances inside your body. And this much, if there is a minuteness, if this even amount it becomes less, it affects your body. It produces the symptoms. It produces the disease. And that is what one has to understand. This is too important to understand. Now we'll go with one more slide. And here he gives that in 1 liter of milk, how much quantity of these salts you can get. In mother's milk, specifically he is mentioning regarding mother's milk in order to explain how it affects the infant's metabolism of a 6 months in. And see, this is what he is giving over here. Compare these with this analysis, that of milk of this 1 liter or 1000 grams contains. The Kali is there, 0.780. Natrum is there, 0.230. Calcarea is there, 0.330. Magnesia is there, 0.060. Iron, 0.004. Iron is less in comparatively in milk. Phosphoric acid, mother's milk, but in mother's milk at least it is present. Phosphoric acid, 0.470. And chlorine, that is chloride, it is 0.440. And traces of fluor and silica. 1 liter, a little over a quart, suffices for the daily food of an infant weighing about 6 kg. That is the 13.14 pounds. See, this mother's milk, 1 liter per day, is sufficient for the child because it provides all the ingredients, all the inorganic salts, and in a proper quantity. And that's why mother's milk is highly digestible to the infant. See, why he is giving or why he is mentioning all those things? He is mentioning all those things that if there is a disturbance or if there is a deficiency in this inorganic salt, this much amount is required. So less. And how you can provide that he wants to compare. Now we'll go ahead with. Now, if 6 centigrams, that is 3.5 of a grain of a magnesia, are sufficient to cover a needful daily supply of magnesia for an infant, how minute must be the dose of magnesia to be given for neuralgia, which is caused by an inconceivably small deficiency of this salt in a minute portion of a nerve tissue? See, this much minute dose of a magnesia is required whenever the nerve pathology is there and you are giving MacFos. You can give it in such a minute quantity, then it works. If you give that MacFos in material doses, it will not work. And that's why he gives so much of importance. He is giving you a number of examples. There are a few more examples. The mineral contents of one cells are infinitely small. According to the calculation of C. Smith, the physiologist, each blood corpuscle contains about 1/1,000,000th part of gram of Kalimur. This corresponds to the 12th decimal trituration. See, 1/1,000,000th part of a gram of a Kalimur equal to 12x potency. And that much Kalimur is required for the body. See, this is scientific community. This is scientific concept. And that's why I believe in this more, because it works according to the doses. Now we'll go ahead further. Similarly, active in very small doses of the remedies used by old school for instant corrosive sublimate, of which Professor Hugo Schutz says that a solution of 1/6 lakh to 1/8 lakhs brings about quite powerful fermentation, one far above the normal, in a grape sugar solution to which yeast has been added. So see how, if you want to make a fermentation, if you want to make a change, how much minute quantity of the things are required. He is giving you examples like this, and these are very important to understand. So he is giving you references to understand all those things. The inorganic substances which serve plants for nutrition are taken up by them only in minimal quantities. Liebig, in his chemical letters, observed that the strongest manure of the earthy phosphates in a coarse powder cannot be compared in its action with a much smaller quantity, finely divided, which by its subdivision can be diffused throughout the soil. See, he is giving you examples of plants. And if these phosphates are given, how much minute quantity a soil requires? Each rootlet requires but a small quantity of nourishment where it is in contact with the soil, but for its functional activity and existence, it is requisite that this minimum may be present just at that spot. So if it has been required at that specific spot, very minute quantity, and then it works. The insoluble minerals, substances found in the soil must be dissolved by the acid juices of the fibers of the root before they can reach the vegetable organism. So they get diluted with the acid juices which are there at the root, and they get absorbed inside the plant, and they, with the help of that, the plant grows, even though it is so minute quantity. So this is the rule, that minute quantity always reflects and it goes and it works inside the human being. All these things he is giving you references in order to explain the importance of a minute dose. Then he goes again with one few more examples. A mineral, when it reaches the human stomach, is acted upon by a muriatic acid contained in the gastric juice. Kay sangitle baka, any mineral, when it reaches the human stomach, it's acted upon by a muriatic acid, manjas ka hydrochloric acid contained in the gastric juice. If this is a salt of iron, the chloride will be formed. Now, if it is desirable to administer the phosphate of iron for therapeutic purposes, it must be kept out of stomach. For this purpose, a minimal dose is required. The medicine must be diluted to such a degree that its molecules may penetrate the epithelium of the mouth, pharynx, esophagus, and reach the blood through the capillary walls. Those substances that are insoluble in water must be trituration to 6 decimal potency. At least those soluble in water may penetrate the epithelial cells in lower dilution. Now he is giving you, if you want to give iron, you must make it small and small, small and small. So if you go in the 6 decimal potency, this is the common potency which is used by the Schussler, and which is required amount is fulfilled with the six potency or 6x potency. And that's why generally in practice we used to use this any salt in 6x potency. These are the references which he is giving in order to explain it. So everything he has tried to explain with the help of a different examples. We'll go ahead with the next slide. In some of the mineral waters, the mineral salts are present only in quantities corresponding to the 6th or 8th decimal dilution. And thus, in waters of rich in gen, magnesia phosphoricum is present only in 8th, Kalimur is in 5th, and silica in 6th dilution. There are so different sources of mineral waters which are used for the purpose of treatment, and number of times patient recovers with mineral waters. Because it contains these salts, and it contains this salt in such a small quantity that it's, it, if you compare with the trituration, you can it can be 8x, 5x, 6x, and same quantity which is required for the body. And then it penetrates and it works and it restores number of functions. And that's why he is giving you a different example. One more example he explains, Dr. Behnke, in his balinological letters, correctly observes that relative proportion and the degree of concentration in which the salt is present in mineral water is of a great importance. Many of the most famous springs owe their good results to the fact that the curative constituents are present only in greatly diluted states, and that the best results are frequently obtained from the doses usually considered very minor. So there are number of things. The people goes to certain places and drinks a water over there, and that water contains minerals. No one knows exactly the concentration, but some scientific study denotes that these contains such inorganic salts, and they are in a so minute quantity. And when they consume, it works at the molecular level and brings the patient out. And that's why cure happens to be there of certain diseases with the help of such mineral waters. The adaptability of the minimal dosage to the end in view is in entire harmony with physiological and chemical facts, as may be seen from the following words of Professor Valentine, the well-known physiologist. So Valentine kay mhantat apan baghu jara. There are 5 minutes still. We'll finish this slide and then we'll conclude and again join. Okay. Nature works everywhere with an infinite number of small magnitudes, which, whether in homogeneous or heterogeneous aggregations, can only be perceived by our relatively obtuse organs of sense when in definite masses. The smallest picture which our eyes perceive proceeds from millions of waves of light. A granule of salt that we are hardly able to taste contains myriads of groups of atoms which no sentient eye will ever view. He is giving the examples. There are a number of things around you which you cannot watch with your naked eye, but which are present and which works, which acts on you. Even at some very minute atoms touches your touch and immediately you feel a taste of it. So things which are not visible to your eye can produce a change. A smell immediately reflects you. You cannot watch that something is entering you or touching your nasal mucous membrane and still you smell. See how much minute it is, but still it works. And that's why when you have to provide a medicine, it should be in such minimum quantity. This fact is also illustrated by the well-known experiments of Professor Kirchhoff and Bunsen with common salt by taking 3 milligrams common salt, less than 1 by 20 of a grain, which are blown into the room containing 60 cubic meter of air. In few minutes, sodium lines appear in the flame containing, standing at the considerable distance, which can be distinguished by the unaided eye. So my 1 grain out of 20 grain, that is 3 milligrams of a common salt spread over there, and there with the help of a infrared technology, they have taken the flames, and it has been found that it happened. So this much minute amount can reflect a change, and this is what these are the all examples in order to explain the importance of minuteness of doses. And this is in order to explain how homeopathic or these biochemic medicines are scientific, even in a very small doses. Modern science gives numerous illustrations of the power of infinitesimal quantities. We'll refer only to very few. One is by that most excellent observer Darwin in his work on insectivorous plants. He says, it is an astonishing fact that so inconceivably minute quantity as 1 by 200 lakhs of a grain, a much smaller quantity than the 6th decimal trituration, the usually prescribed strength of the tissue remedies of ammonia phosphate, should induce changes in the gland sufficient to cause a motor impulse to be sent down the whole length of tentacle, with this impulse exciting movements through the angle of about 180 degrees. See, why he is explaining all those things? He wants to explain, even in so minute quantity, that is up to the 6th decimal scale, these things works and produces changes in the nerves. These things produces changes everywhere inside the system. And that's why when you are providing these deficiencies, providing those salts in cases of deficiency, this should be given in such small quantity. So I think the very few slides are remaining. After finishing that, we'll learn the ferrum phosphoricum. But instead of getting disturbed in between, I will suggest Vinod that he conclude the meeting and join it again. We'll join it again so that we'll learn thereafter continuously the ferrum phosphoricum and few slides of this theory. So, Dr. Vinod, please conclude the session and we'll join it again.
Yes.